Stitches is an Irish-made film from 2012, and it's everything a slasher comedy should be. The film was about a clown called Stitches who was accidentally killed at a kid's party, and he's then resurrected years later to kill each of the kids responsible for his death in funny, gruesome ways. Stitches himself was a blast to watch, he's hilarious and horrifying, a perfect blend for a good time. Honestly, the whole cast is so much fun to watch. Unlike a lot of slashers that are filled with shallow characters, this film sets itself apart with every scene being genuinely enjoyable. So less rambling, and let's get into it. The film opens up and we see that Stitches likes to live life on the edge. In this fancy establishment, he's blowing out some bird's back door, and you know what they say, when one door closes, another opens. And he's off to
do some little bastard's party.
He drives over, using his feet to steer, and I can only assume his still erect penis for the pedals, as this diagram shows. He pulls up to the party, almost killing the kids.
Get out of the way, you little bastards!
And this character really shines best through his dialogue, and we get a great example as he approaches the mother of the birthday boy.
You're fucking ugly.
So the party commences and the children terrorise Stitches the entire time.
Everybody happy?
And one of the
little bastards
ties his laces together, then the birthday boy, Tom, throws a ball at him, causing him to fall back onto the dishwasher. Which unfortunately for Stitches didn't follow health and safety regulations, so he ends up with a kitchen knife right through the skull. He isn't dead yet though, he gets up, pulls his knife out, smothers the boy in blood and lunges to stab little Tom. He slips and gets stabbed in the exact same spot. We skip a couple of days later and Tom is watching Stitches' funeral from afar. That night, Tom decides to pay his respects at Stitches' grave, where he accidentally stumbles upon a clown ritual. The clowns find him and tell him that a clown can never rest until the party is finished, whatever that means. We then skip 6 years later and little Tom evolves into Tommy Knight, who you probably recognise from Doctor Who if you're a little nerd, or Waterloo Road if you're a 40-year-old housewife. He goes downstairs where we discover his PTCD, and he imagines his food as a clown. After brekkie, he leaves and reminisces on the only time a woman has touched him. Bit weird considering she's about 8 here.
He's only meeting her for friendly way.
The film goes on to give us nearly 45 minutes of character development, and unlike most slashes, it's actually enjoyable to watch. The chemistry between the cast is just amazing, they sell the team relationships and moments so well to me. Tom arrives at school and we meet the rest of the
little bastards.
Bulger, Vinny, Richie, Kate, Sarah and Paul. These lot remain friends, but these two have turned to little cunts. After meeting them, we get a scene in the classroom where Tom, due to his PTCD, daydreams his teacher as a clown, and he rips his mate's cock off. And I've got to give it to Tom, he does have a creative mind. We then get a little scene after school that day, where Tom is being a peeping Tom and peeps on Kate for a bit, before we go back to school the next day. While there, they plan a party for Tom, as it's his birthday on the weekend and he's got a free house. So that night, Vinny decides to make a public invite to the party. And while he's posting the party around, he decides to take a quick wank break. And rather from the wind or from Vinny's aggressive movement, a flyer from the party goes out and conveniently lands on Stitches' grave. Then we finally arrive at the party day. Lots of people turn up, it's not Project X level, but it's a decent outcome. Each of the kids from the party at the start of the film are all going to show up at some point. There is also an unwanted guest coming though, as we see Stitches come from the grave. So I guess clowns are like vampires in a way, they can only come to a party if invited. During the party, the lads share a weed cookie, and Tom eats the majority of it.
Dude, give me that cookie.
I hate it.
You ate the whole thing.
So he's a baked potato by the time Kate shows up, making him very awkward when he talks to her. She's like the love interest, if you couldn't tell already. This also probably makes it 1,000 times scarier for him, when Paul walks in dressed as a clown to scare him. I mean, it wouldn't be a slasher about someone pretending to be the killer at some point in the film. So he runs off and then falls down some stairs, and while everyone is distracted with the fake clown, the real Stitches arrives at the party. So now we're going to get into the meat of the film, as each kid from the party will be creatively killed off one by one. Before we get our first kill though, we get a scene where Kate and Tom go into the treehouse and Kate finds out about his telescope pointed at her house. She does the same thing and calls him a pervert then tries to leave, but Tom basically just tells her, yeah, I was looking at you, and she's like, oh, okay, cool. He then starts chatting about some clown rituals and stuff.
No, I've got stuff here on medieval jesters, Pueblo Indian delight makers, ancient Egyptian rib tickling ceremonies.
What are these?
When a person becomes a clown, they have to paint their face on an egg.
And I looked into it and some of this is actually true, and it's actually a tradition where clowns do paint an egg. It's done to act as like a copper rope for each clown's individual makeup. Now onto the first kill. Paul's walking around trying to find somewhere to piss and ends up just pissing himself as he's an amateur clown and can't get out of his costume fast enough.
Oh, not again.
While Jane is pissy clothes over the balcony into some pool lad's drink, Stitches shows up and gives him some body modifications before taunting him and then booting his head off straight into a lake.
Front row seat to my comeback show.
And man, the kills in this film were just amazing. The practical effects are done really well, and what makes it more impressive is the film's really low budget. Stitches then uses his nose to sniff out his next victim. He sniffs out Bulger, who's in the pantry stuffing his face. And unfortunately for him, a banger comes on as he's being killed, so the volume goes up and no one can hear his screams. Stitch is used as an ice cream scooper and takes out chunks of his brain and even gives it a nice drizzle of blood over them to top it off. Sarah then walks in, but Stitch is used as puppeteering skills to fool her. And a lot of clown films ditch the clown aspect and just use it as a costume, and I love how this film keeps him acting as a clown. Like for example when he pulls a bunny out of Paul's mouth and like this. It's a perfect way to make your killer funny without them having to ruin the horror factor. Stitches does a little waddle away to go find his next victims. Vinny sexually assaults a girl, but in a fun way, and they run upstairs to do some unholy business, bumping into Sarah on their way. She's looking for her now dead boyfriend, and she goes up into the attic to find him. Instead of finding Paul, she runs straight into Stitches. Stitches goes to the killer, but she gives him a heel in the throat, but unfortunately, he's not going down that easy. She tries to run away and gets an umbrella through her skull, taking her eyeball out on the point of the umbrella, and as she falls down, the eyeball falls back into her open mouth. And then the umbrella opens up, painting the room with her insides. From behind. Tom is still up in the treehouse peeping in the party, and he sees Stitches in the window. So he grows some balls and he runs over to alert his mates while Stitches murders the family cat and goes on to find his next victim. Richie is up next. He's off to smoke a cheeky joint and we get my favourite kill of the film. Stitches cuts him across the stomach and rips his guts out and makes a dog out of them. And this links back to when Richie was a child and pops Stitches' balloon. One of the little details I love in this film is that for each kill, Stitches does it in a way which relates to how they treated him as a child. He then takes a few selfies of him and then sticks a bike pump into his head and pumps up until it explodes. And yeah, this is probably the most memorable part of the film. While that was happening, Tom cop-locks Vinny to tell him about Stitches. So Vinny goes upstairs and sees dead bodies. So he runs back down into the room to get his clothes on.
Hey, put your knickers on, we're leaving. Hey, come on, there's a killer clown in the house.
Is there? I'd like to meet him. Sounds like a fun guy.
They have a quick scuffle with Stitches and escape the room. They almost make it out, but Tom is simping over Kate, so they go in to find her first. Kate is actually downstairs with the rest of the party, when Stitches does a funny little run and jumps through the window. So they all run away. Stitches gives us a funny one-liner and decks Kate, then tries to drown Tom in a sink full of puke, which is just rank to even think about. He uses washing up liquid in the fridge to get away, and Kate stabs him in the eye for a third time. So they both run out of the house, they grab a bike each, and they're heading over to the cemetery. This is because Tom believes if they destroy Stitches' egg, they may be finally able to kill him. So Chase commences, and I absolutely love this race. The fact he just grabs the littlest bike, and then when he goes uphill, he just picks up the bike and carries on walking with it rather than just ditching it. They arrive at the graveyard and they head towards the clown tomb while Stitches is doing some tightroping. Running would be a lot quicker, but I guess clowns stick to what they know. Kate and Tom make their way to the tomb and find the egg wall. Tom climbs up and ends up knocking the whole shelf down. Mission failed successfully, I guess. Tom opens up the case, but before he can open it, Stitches catches him. So he has them both at knife point, holding his egg, and he asks them,
"Which is funnier, the look on your face watching her die, or the look on her face watching you die?"
Little does he know, Vinny is sneaking up to tie his laces, just like they did when he was a kid. So Tom bars in time by proposing a coin toss to decide who dies first. And Stitches could never refuse a game like that. So Tom tosses the coin straight over into Stitches' face. This causes him to fall, but luckily the clown though stops the egg from cracking. But wait, here comes Tom out of nowhere and stamps his head down onto the egg. And this causes every part of Stitches to explode in a great final kill. And I feel like this really tops off the film, and it was a really cool way to tie the egg into the plot. We get a few more minutes to film, they just round things off and show us that Kate and Tom are now together now. And they also show us the clown putting Stitches' egg back together. Unfortunately, they never made a sequel, but to be fair, that's the big issues with a lot of slasher films, they don't know when to stop. For a lot of horror fans, this would be a really refreshing watch. Dialogue is hilarious throughout, and the constant banter just makes it feel real to me. It's just one of those films where it feels like a lot of care went into every aspect. I also love every kill in the film, they're all just so creative, and it really sets itself apart from low-budget horrors, and any horror to be honest. Ross Noble did a really great job with Stitches, and I highly doubt anyone could have done a better job than him. If you're looking for a good time, this is definitely the film to check out. And although you've seen the whole plot, I guarantee you'll still have a great time watching it. Anyway, that's all for today, and if you made it to the end, I'd really appreciate it, and goodbye.